Hi guys, I'm glad you're all here. Thank you very much for joining me. Puerto Rico's been a rocking and rolling here on USGS. They got 35 earthquakes just within the last 24 hours. The largest being a magnitude 4.5. 17 earthquakes of a magnitude 2.5 or greater. There's also been a 4.0. That one was between the Mona Passage, Puerto Rico, and Cuba. It was deep, 77.7 miles below sea level. We got the Puerto Rican trench through here. There's the 4.5. Let me bring it over so you can see it. Kind of northeast. One person there in Puerto Rico said they actually felt it. 14.9 miles below sea level. And that's it for the largest ones. Yeah, 4.5 and a 4.0. I first want to mention how the data came from UPR Seismic Network, which is the Puerto Rico Seismic Network. The reason I'm bringing this up is for some reason, everything is supposed to be by universal time, but their universal time has been off. So it's supposed to be 3:47, but here's the earthquake actually at 3:34. And I have three different monitors that I downloaded data from. The larger one over here by Cuba, for some reason, the seismic station there in Cuba doesn't pick up any earthquakes. Let's see, one of the monitors that I downloaded was this one right here. LONE3 was one. On the southern end of the island is DRSC01. There's the one location. And LOBH, way down here towards the south. Let me take this out. The red line is the Puerto Rican trench. Now, you know, many of the earthquakes that have been occurring today were north. And this one here picked up the most activity, LONE3. So that would be this one right here, LONE3. And I'll bring it down. You can see it's really been rocking. Yeah, north of the island. LOBH and SC01. So here's that 4.5 earthquake. As you know, these are all volcanic islands. Puerto Rico slowly being crushed, pushed down into the middle of the Caribbean Sea. We also got another one here marked in red at 10:36. Because our time is off, I believe this is supposed to be a magnitude 2.2. And about 1628, they got two marked in red. And it actually looks like a comb, don't it? Let me bring this over. Yeah, I thought that was really, yeah, talking about steady drum beats, huh? And we'll look at the spectrogram. Yeah, that was shallow. We have another earthquake here at 1638. You know, with that many earthquakes, I'm not going to be able to go through them all. We got some more up here at, 1917. Looks like they got three marked there. And we'll look at its seismic signature. Yeah. And 1819. There's a whole series of them marked out there in red. But it's one very long, slow-moving tectonic earthquake. Yeah, and let's look at this stuff. Look at the little drum beats. I'll try and make that bigger for you. Yep, lots of activity today. And these are shallow. These are quite shallow. Here's one of the other monitors. LOBH. Try and get a comparison of the exact time. 1742. 1742 at SCO1. And there's the three spectrograms all lined up. Yeah. Okay, SCO1. That would be this earthquake here. And let's bring it in. Santo Domingo. Yeah. And like I said, this is a volcanic island, and so it doesn't surprise me that, yeah, it's showing the gases coming up in the one, and yeah, lots of magma in the other. Here's what it was showing when I pulled the files a little while ago. 1748 in about 30 seconds. And the same with this one over here. And yeah, look at this one over here. Look at those gases coming up. Now this one here is LONE3. Almost directly from the other one right there. You'd be saying, oh my goodness, do they have a volcano that's going to erupt soon? Hard to say. I doubt it. But it is showing that because of the movement of the North American plate and the crushing that's going on, yeah, we got a lot of activity happening. You know, this poor people on this poor island have had some really devastating earthquakes and hurricanes. And they're part of the United States, but they can't vote in any of our elections, which I don't think is fair. I believe it was one of the more recent hurricanes where a lot of the people came here to the United States, and then they were forced to go back. That ain't fair either. Yeah, last year, in August, they had a magnitude 7.2 earthquake. Over 304 people were killed and over 1,800 injuries. In 1842, they had a magnitude 8.1. Most of the larger earthquakes have always been on the western side of the island. See, 1751, there was a magnitude 8.0. That one, I believe, there was a tsunami about 30-some feet high, liquefaction. And because the sand, etc., all turned to quicksand, in a sense, liquefaction. Yes, there was people that died. They were buried, sunk up to their necks in the sand. Yeah, just terrible. In just the past week alone, there's been 140 earthquakes. And we got this location north, but majority of them have been down here to the southwest. Yeah. Now, once again, this is just within the last week, the largest being a 3.5, 7.5 miles below sea level. On the 9th, there was a 3.1, right up over here, right there. And that one was deep, 47.6 miles below sea level. Yeah, so we got the 3.3, the 3.1, and the 3.5, that was on the 6th. In total, for the entire month, let's see, there's been 445 earthquakes. Earthquakes have really increased just in the last week, 115. As I have said before in my other reports about earthquakes there in Puerto Rico, yeah, please be prepared. Always have a plan. And it's hard to be prepared when you got such a poor part of the United States, and you can't even vote. That's not right. So what are your thoughts? Put those comments down below. Thank you very much for watching. Thank you for subscribing. Please stay safe, and I will talk to you later. God bless you. Bye.